complaining spirits, hindering spirits, retaliatory spirits, deceiving spirits, religious spirits, occult spirits, witchcraft spirits, including Jezebel, Delilah, and Apollyon. I bind all curses that have been spoken against us, and we bless those who curse us, and we pray blessings on those who despitefully use us. We bind all spoken judgments made against us and judgments that we have made against others. We bind the power of negative words from others, and we bind and render useless all prayers not inspired by the Holy Ghost, whether psychic, soul force, witchcraft, or counterfeit tongues that have been prayed against us. We are God's children. We resist the devil. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. We put on the whole armor of God. We take authority over this day in Jesus' name. Let it be prosperous for us. Let us walk in your love, Lord. The Holy Spirit leads and guides us today. We discern between the righteous and the wicked. We take authority over Satan and all his demons and those people who are influenced by them. We declare that Satan is under our feet and shall remain there forever. We are the righteousness in Christ Jesus. We are God's property. Satan, you are bound from our families, our minds, our bodies, our homes, our finances. We confess that we are healed and whole. We flourish and have a long, stable life, full of peace, patience, and love. We have authority over Satan and all his demons in Jesus' name. God, we pray for the ministry that you have given us. Anoint us for all you have called us to do. We call forth divine appointments, open doors of opportunity, God-ordained encounters, and ministry positions. We claim a hedge of protection around us throughout the night and day. We ask you, Father, in the name of Jesus, to dispatch angels to surround us and our entire family, houses, cars, souls, and bodies. We ask angels to protect our homes from any intrusions and to protect our families from harmful demonic, physical, or mental attacks. We ask this prayer in the name of Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise. Amen. You may be seated. Praise the Lord. We just thank God for just covering us, amen? And just keeping us daily. We give honor to our apostle and his wife. Tonight, we give honor to our viewing audience tonight and all of you here tonight, amen? We ask that if the ministers could come sit on the front row, also one that's close to the fire, amen, to pray in the spirit. Thank you. You can just move my stuff out the way. Everyone to lift up Minister Latrice Reese family. She's they're at the point dealing with her grandmother. The organs are shutting down, and so she's been around longer than expected. Amen. And so she's not going to be here tonight. So she just asked that we all just keep her lifted up in prayer. Amen. Just keep the family. I know her father is here. And her grandmother's passing over. Amen. And some family members can handle it better than others. But the word of the Lord said he comfort all that mourns. Amen.
Amen.
So we just pray for the spirit of comfort to be upon them and their family tonight. Amen.
Yes.
The upcoming events, we are going to have August the 20th at 9 a.m. We are going to have evangelism. Soldiers for Christ will be feeding in the Thompson Park, and it's right down the street on Bellflower Boulevard on the left-hand side before you get to past the 91 freeway, but it's the next freeway. Before you get to the 105, it's going to be on the left-hand side. And so we are asking for donations such as bread and water, sandwich meat, cookies, chips. You can see myself or Minister Brenda, so we can go out because we're going to do evangelism and go out soul seeking and soul winning, amen, and also feed as well. Give the Lord a hand of praise. For this sure enough, this been time, amen. And then on August the 26th, from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m., Saturday morning, we have a night of intercession. It's a clarion call to all intercessory prayer warriors to come forth and pray against the enemy's attacks on this nation. And we're just asking everybody to come out that is able to come out and just unify in the spirit, amen. And that's what God is calling apostles to do as well, to come. We got to come together and pray. One can fight 1,000, but two can put 10,000 to flight. So just imagine if all of us come together, amen, what God can do in the spirit realm. Amen? And just praying, because it's very crazy out there. There's a lot of stuff going on. It is ridiculous. And it made me not want to look at the news. And because if you look at the news, you'll keep, get your eyes off of Jesus. Amen? He said, keep our eyes lifted unto the author, what? And the finisher of our faith. So our faith is in the Most High God, amen? And there's a lot of distractions all around on this Facebook and all kind of stuff is just, it's crazy. The calls you get regarding stuff that is so petty, but yet it's real big to somebody else. And it's big to them because they don't know the Most High God, amen? So we're just going to keep everybody lifted up in prayer. And again, that's August the 26th at 26th. Friday, August the 26th, 10 p.m. to 6 a.m., amen? And we are expecting God to move in the shut-in, amen? Starting Friday, September the 2nd, at 7 p.m., we will be having a Friday night fire, prophetic healing deliverance. I don't know what God is going to do, but I know he's going to move mightily, amen? And that'll be Friday, September the 2nd, at 7 p.m., that service will be starting. Saturday, September the 10th, from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m., we're going to have a single conference. And we want you to see Minister Joanne Harris for details. It was an awesome conference last night. The women, last year, the women were blessed. People got delivered in the service. It was just, they had wonderful speakers. Prophetess Rusha, Minister Deanne. Was it last year? You was the year before? 15? The singles conference. Yeah, you were on there. Minister, I think it was Minister Deanne. It was several ladies on there. And it was beautiful. And it was just laid out. And people were truly blessed. I was blessed. Amen. It was just a blessing because everyone had a different outlook of where their perspective was regarding their walk as a single woman of God. Amen. And it impacted everybody. I gained something from every woman that spoke. Amen. I gained some wisdom, knowledge, and some understanding. Amen. What to do and what not to do. Amen. Even though as a married woman, you still can learn. It doesn't matter. You learn. Because you weren't always married. We weren't always married. We had to get single, and God gave that man that good thing when he gave him us. Amen. And something went forth from there. But whenever God puts something together, you know the enemy is going to try to kill, steal, and destroy. Amen? So I just gained a lot of wisdom from the women of God because it's hard being a single man or woman of God and you trying to walk upright in the things of the Lord. And it's a struggle sometimes. But if you got your eyes fixed on Jesus, everything is smooth. But yeah, the enemy going to try you. He's going to try you. It's all about you sitting and moving in the spirit for the devil, amen? Never know how he's going to come, when he's going to come, but we have to be prepared at all times, amen? Prepared with the whole armor. But he say, go, Satan. He going to look at you and laugh. But you say, Satan, the Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus, amen? He got a backup, amen? So it was a beautiful time last year. I was truly blessed. So see Minister Joanne Harris for details. And As we know, the big day, October the 1st, 2016, the first Saturday in October, we're having the International Gathering of the Warriors Encounter, amen? That will be held in at the Jane and William Auditorium, 16600 Civic Center Drive, Bellflower Boulevard, Bellflower, California, 90706. There, and this is the flyer. As you know, a lot of people, they're questioning if the event is free or if it's a ticketed event. It is a free event, amen. It's free parking, amen. It's free, the parking is free. You can promote your ministry for free, amen. If you have 15, as far as the pastors, you have 15 people that you bring to the event, you are able to go into the green room. You don't know who God is going to connect you with, amen? But God has given Apostle the vision and has ordained this thing to take place, amen? Predestined and ordained by God for this to go forth. And that event will also be honoring. God is going to honor people in that event. We're going to be praying on that day for the nations, you know, the things that are going on, the attacks that's against the nation. It's a lot of things God is going to do in this event. And so anybody that you can tell, we had a meeting on Sunday, that you want to spread the word, spread the word. We're going to have some more of these flyers made up. Give Minister Amanda a hand because she's working behind the scene. You don't really see her up front a lot. But she works behind the scene. Give Minister Deanne a hand because she created this flyer. Amen. She's working all the way all across the water over there in Fiji Islands. Amen. So she's still working behind the scenes to make sure things are going smooth here for the Sword of the Spirit. She's also promoting this online on the page, on the website. Amen. So just let people know it is free. And God is going to move mightily. I told Apostle on, I think it was Sunday, I'm excited in my spirit. It's like, I don't know what God is going to do, but I know it's a great expectation. And it's like my spirit, like, you know, when you're pregnant and you feel that baby flutter in your belly, when they first start moving around, that's how I feel in my belly. It's like a great expectation because God is going to move mightily. Amen. He's going to do something. People are going to get healed and delivered. They're going to get impartations. They're going to get breakthroughs. There's going to be doors that's going to be. Oh, this is all the stuff the Holy Spirit telling me is going to take place on October the 1st. Amen. Can I get a witness? Because I know he's telling some of you all. Amen. Something mighty is going to. It's not just. The Lord told me, he said, it's going to be a mind-blowing and a life-changing experience. Amen. And when the queen and the king stand on the same ground together, it's going to be a shaking in the heavens. God told me this in December last year. He said it's going to be a shaking in the heavens. It's been a fight. It has been a fight in the spirit realm. But we thank God that she's going to be here at this event. Amen. And it's going to be a shaking in the heavens. Amen. And I'm in a great, great expectation. I'm just excited in my spirit because I know God is going to do something. And the sword of the Spirit will not be the same, nor the people in the sword of the Spirit. Amen. Give the Lord a hand of praise. I dealt with a deliverance earlier today, and it was from the time. It was a major one. You can tell. It was major, and I have a headache like nobody's business, but to God be the glory, the young lady was delivered. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 31 years old, but she was delivered. I mean, stuff that happened to her when she was a little bitty girl. Hallelujah. And she began to call out these things. She just called out everything. She called that thing out. And she was declaring and praying. I mean, she was speaking the word of God that I didn't even know she had in her. Amen. But it was a beautiful thing. She said she told the Lord, have your way. Have your way. She said, I told the Lord I was going to stop smoking at this time. And I told the Lord I'm going to stop drinking at this time. Hallelujah. She had her set time. She was going to stop. But she said on Sunday morning, her husband looked at her kind of crazy because she used to play in her R&B music. Amen. She said, but Sunday, she said, I got up and I put on some spiritual music. So he looked at me kind of funny. Amen. She said, sometimes you have to change the atmosphere. And she said, for the last 2 days, the Lord had just been pulling on her and pulling on her. And I got home today, and I mean, he was pulling on her. And I wasn't expecting all of that. But I mean, he had her to call out everything that happened to her and then replace it with his word.
Amen.
And she said, I felt so heavy. She said, I felt so heavy and burning down. She said, I was angry. She said, I was angry with everybody. The devil wanted her to be to herself. She said, I was just angry. Everybody, I didn't want nobody to look at. I was angry at my children. She said, I was angry with my husband because she was molested. But she was just angry. And people don't understand when stuff like that happens and you're violated, other spirits come in with that spirit.
Yeah.
And it caused you to act in a way that you don't know.
Yeah.
Because you don't know all what that person that has violated you done. You don't know what they've been through.
Yeah. Yeah.
So when that spirit comes to you and it opens you up, it all everything comes within that person.
Yeah.
And so she's looking at, you know, men, and then she's looking at her husband. She was saying, I hated my husband. I hated my children. And she said, and I kept trying to judge the person. I kept trying to judge my husband, why he doing this and why he's doing that. She said, but God had to remind me that that was you.
Yeah.
And I told her, I said, whenever you point that finger, see that trigger point back at you? Whenever you point that finger at somebody, you're pointing it back at yourself. And the Holy Spirit, she said, he just brought conviction. He was talking to me so much, I didn't want to hear him. She didn't want to hear it because he started telling her what you did,
yeah.
How you did.
Yeah.
You did it like this, but you trying to tell them how they did it. You trying to remind me what they did. But what if I reminded you of everything you do, you would want to go bury your head somewhere. Yeah. Amen?
Amen?
So she was set free. 31 years old. She released 30, y'all I'm gonna see. 31 years of baggage was released out of this young woman of God today.
Amen.
And God has an awesome call. To God be all the glory.
Amen.
He have a set time for each and every one of us.
Amen.
To be delivered and set free.
Amen.
Amen. Give the Lord a hand of praise. Amen. But God is so awesome. She said, I feel so light. I felt like some best stuff kind of tried to jump out. My head's hurting me so bad. I had to take extra strength. Tylenol. And I don't get headaches. Amen. But all is well because the devil don't stop no shows. Amen. We just keep on pushing in the Holy Spirit. Amen. He said we gotta press toward the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. So sometimes God will let that stuff come on you so you can take the weight off of those. He said, we, the strong bear the infirmities of the weak, amen? So it'll pass. It'll pass. But I just said, Lord, don't let nothing stay in my spirit. That I just kept praying. He had me praying in the spirit the whole time. But she was set free today. 31 years of baggage. And I know she felt like a feather. Afterwards, she said, I feel like I just fly. I could just float. I said, I feel like floating for you. Amen. To God be the glory. I'm just trying to pass time until Pastor come out. Amen. But you never know what somebody is going through. You never know. And we have to be prepared. Even though you don't feel like hearing that, you know, she just started talking one way and deliverance started taking place.
Amen.
She just called talking, and it would deliver us over the phone.
Amen.
I said, God, you are so awesome. I'm excited in my spirit. Amen. Is that Bishop? Bishop? Oh my God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He was in my spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is awesome. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Stand at this time to receive our apostle. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I just have to say this. I was praying for this man of God. I haven't seen you in a long time. Amen.
Amen.
But you was in my spirit yesterday, and I began to pray. I got a little seat. I was praying for you. And I think I mentioned it. I told my apostle, you was in my spirit. And here you are walking into the house of God. Give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Stand at this time. We thank you for standing and receive our apostle. Amen. Give him a hand as he comes.
Give the Lord a hand, baby. Let's worship God. Let's worship. Let's worship.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord, we praise you. Let's get a man who got a hand praise. God is really something. when he puts a minimum guy on the prophet's heart, there's something he got in store for that person. That's amazing. How are you? You get a lot of other hand praise. That's amazing. God is an amazing guy, that's how I say it. He's going to do something for his ministry. It's for the international gathering of the warriors. It was in the heart of God. When I came home Sunday, I was sitting there meditating, and I heard a voice say, "They shall come from around the world." And I started crying. That's the vision he has for this event in the future. When he speaks this in the future, now I'm in the present tense. I'm not telling people from the word. I'm telling people from coming. So if you don't come down, the man called him the Paul, he wanted to come. Raise his hand. I said, no, he's on a one-day event and we'll start. In the future, it will be a three-day conference. People will come from all over the world. And this house will be magnified. And this ministers in this house will pull to nations. You will see. They have this sort of spirit. God will be anointing to so many times. He said, they will come from around the world. This is something they wanted to do. I've done everything else. Established international ministry. Got two sort of schools in Africa. Got 39 pastors in Africa. 14 ministries with sort of schools now. 30 ministries with two different churches. Close to maybe 100 churches from parts of the world. So, me and the Lord in the room telling me the sort of ministry that I couldn't tell anybody. And 4 years he did that. He showed me everything, he showed me the kind of past. He showed me about this, this man saying. And every time he showed me something, it's only like a beginning. Or something. Mm-hmm. It's like he showed me the Africa with my air coordinator and David and the Arab there. And he showed me that place. It's just the beginning of something great. And I want to speak to this house and let you know that you are a very, I say, a great position to be in the spirit. And God is doing something on his own through you. And I applaud each and every one of you for this ministry. You've been chosen by God for something great. And I might not be able to see it. I speak it and decree it that way. That even from the past. All the ministries of this ministry. This tangible anointing, this whole house, will be upon your ministries. And people will pull you around the world to be a part of this anointing. But God has ordained it for the foundation of the world. humbled. You have chosen me to be a vessel to use and to be in obedience to this will. You have shown me that there's a lot of sacrifice you have to go through to get to this that I have accomplished. You know, you showed me the time that you have shown me the sacrifices. The deep pain and the wounds that was inflicted upon me on this journey. And he said, he did a healing in my spirit, like a moan came up deep out of my spirit. And so he did a inner healing for the abuse that I went through to do what he wanted to do. I'm here to let you know, this is serious business up in here. It's very serious business, so it's good. It's a method of play. I'm telling you now, this is my church's room. This is serious. The last person here were witnesses was Bishop Ross. He was in that room. He saw it himself. He's a witness. This is God. By himself. And every person walking that door, they can be led by the Spirit. What are you doing here? That the Spirit led you. He led you in his house. He has something great to do for him and his kingdom. So this is the kingdom house. This is not church. This is kingdom. It's all about what he led down through you. And it's very serious. I'm going to do my part as I'm the shepherd here. You do your part. You'll see the blessings of the Lord on your mind. Let's see the Lord in the family. Certain kind of classes, training a little bit. But I will do the best I can in the strength I have. Amen. Bow your heads. Go ahead and find out, come before you as a good vessel, Father. I surrender to you. Heal your spirit and your word. Speak to me and to me. Give me the teachers of mountain and the people of mountain. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Give our hand praise. Amen. Well, again, welcome to the school of the class of how to develop the mind of Christ. That is our fourth session. Amen. And I will continue on, and we're going to start, went over this last week, and we'll start with Romans. Eighth chapter, verse 1 through 17. Yeah. It says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death. But what the law could not do, and that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness, notice that, of sinful flesh, and for sin, he came for sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us. Go ahead again. That the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us. Those who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh. But they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. To be carnally minded is death. But to be spiritually minded is life and peace. because the carnal mind is enmity against God, but it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. But ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God dwells in you. Notice that. If the Spirit of God dwells in you, you are not in the flesh, you are in the spirit. Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. I'm going to pause here. Like I was talking to you about people in the church that have only operating on a dead faith, intellectual faith, and they have not had that encounter of the Spirit. They're operating from their intellect, from their psyche, their mind, the will, the emotion, and their intellect. They haven't had been dwelling in the Spirit, yet they're in the house of God, expecting the benefits of a child of God. And that's why he had me to stop and go back, make sure people in the house know that they are truly saved. A lot of people in the house of God are not saved. And a lot of preachers don't take the time to find out if they're truly saved, because they come to church and they might confess Jesus Lord, but they're not living it. Like I said, everybody want to be saved, but nobody want the Lord with them. They talk the talk but don't walk the walk. They are the hypocrites. They're pretenders. So you ministers, you have to make sure different people that they truly are saved. You still gonna have people who are gonna play it, but that's up to them. But you have to give them the opportunity and teach them that particular truth about that dynamic faith. A faith that affects the soul, the body, and the spirit. All three parts. Like I said, the demons, it affects their, you know, intellect and their emotions. That's why they believe it, they know it's God, they do. And they tremble. That's their emotion. We can know that people are saved. This is critical for the body of Christ. There are so many priests out there trying to build ministries and get numbers and have mega ministries, and they're not caring about the people's souls. And all they're doing is have a certain platform to draw the people and become big. It's not about their soul. We as ministers got to be concerned about the people around us that are truly saved. We're not operating on dead faith. He said, now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin. But the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh, to live after the flesh. But if you live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify or kill the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bear witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, If so, be that we suffer with him. I go over that again. If so, be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. See, there's some suffering when you come into this. And people don't want to teach the people. They talk about just a part. You're going to be blessed. You're going to be blessed. You're going to be blessed. But the word says you're going to suffer. And that's why a lot of people leave the church, because they come in for the blessing. When the suffering comes, oh, I don't want no part of that. Because all the preacher did is teach them about the blessings. How many people here teaching these, maybe talking about the sufferings? Teaching the people to suffer, you're going to suffer. You're going to suffer. There's a suffering. And one of the fruits of the Spirit is long suffering. Nobody wants to suffer. But that's what you have to surrender yourself to the suffering in order for the completion of the process. Oh, you understand this thing. You're on a journey. You are passing through here. This is only a temporary existence. You are facing eternity. You're facing an eternity. Nothing wrong with being blessed. I want to be blessed. But I understand the blessing comes after the suffering. Then weeping may endure for a night, but joy shall come in the morning. You have valley experiences, then you have mountain experiences, mountaintop experiences. It's a journey. Like I was telling the Lord, I was praying to him, thank you for my journey. So I was telling the Lord, thank you for my journey. And each and every one of us got to the point where we thank him for all the stuff we have been through. The good, the bad, the ugly, and the indifferent, we are to thank him for that. He said all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord, who call according to his purpose. Those valley experiences is preparation for your mountaintop experiences. You're passing through. Don't stay there. Some folks stay in the valley. And they make their home in the valley. I get tired of hearing folks like that. Every time you call them, crying the blues. Yeah. Man, it took so long. Man, wait a minute here. Something wrong. You know, for year to year, you still in that same valley. Something wrong. You done built your house in the valley. You're looking up at the mountaintop. I will be passing through. Get to the and build my house on the mountaintop. Amen. Amen? Amen. But this is an individual thing. Yeah. It's individual. We're going to suffer. There's some things you're going to have to, he's going to take you through. To get you where he wants you to go. Yeah. And you cannot fight against it. You have to go through it. Yeah. When God takes you through a test, I'm telling you something. It has a starting point and an ending point. He's going to give you that rest and that peace if you go through this thing. I know what I went through my late life. Years of suffering. Years of it. But I come to understand he was doing something inside of me. He was teaching me something for me to be what he wanted me to be. I had to learn something through the suffering of taking care of him by myself. Jesus died before me. He wanted to teach me something.
And the things you go through, you might not be able to see it until you get past it and you can look back on it. But when you go through it, when you're in it, it's hard to see. When you're drowning, it's hard to see. But once you come out of it, you can look back. And reflection. We're going to go through some things. Everything not going to be great all the time. Yeah. I call it the process to purpose.
Amen.
The process to purpose. I go ahead and keep on going. The first characteristic of the Christ mind is alive, like I said. It responds to Philippians 2. Being spiritually alive is related to Christ's freedom. Genuine freedom can occur only where spiritual life exists. Life is not fully spiritual until it is fully free. I repeat that. Life is not fully spiritual until it is fully free. See, the devil want to bind you. You have to be free in the spirit. You have to have a liberty in the spirit. Freedom. That's right. We cannot control people. Come on. They have to be, to be alive, they have to be free. There's a freedom in the spiritual walk. In the spiritual life, there's a liberty of freedom. And on that journey, he'll take you to different places in your development, in his walk. And he give you revelation and understanding of the depthness of him on your journey. He's revealing. It's like layers on an onion have to come off of you. Layers, layers, layers have to come off of you in order for him to get you where he wants you to be in him. That he'll operate through you. It's a yielding of your spirit to him. It's a yielding of your spirit. You know, I get it. James 3:17. Get James 3:17. We don't deal with the ordered mind of Christ. This scripture, James 3:17 says, the wisdom that is from above is first pure. Underline the word pure. Then peaceable. Underline peaceable. Gentle. And easy to be entreated. Now that word entreated, it threw me off and I went to study it. Entreated, entreated. That's how about the treat. It did it say negotiation, intercession, and treat, how to treat. It got very big. So to be entreatable means that you gotta be where a person come to you. Yeah, approachable. And if they get to the point where they're pleading to you or begging you, you can't be so hard-hearted. You gotta be treatable. You gotta be able to treat that person like you want to be treated. You gotta be, you know, and, you know, you might say no, but you might have a thing to be willing to say yes on certain situations. There's a chip, that's all, that goes along with gentleness. You can be hard-hearted. Have you dealt with a hard-hearted person before? I mean, nothing can penetrate that heart. Intrinsic.
And it says, full of mercy and good fruits, without partiality and without hypocrisy. In developing the mind of Christ in you, God guides you to get rid of wrong desires and replace them with his desires. Yeah. Knowing how Jesus thought and what he showed concern for can help you understand what he wants to develop in you. Mm-hmm. Like today, we're going to start the process of the 17 virtues that are true of Christ's mind. I want you to memorize James 3:17. Amen. Now we're going to deal with the 8 virtues that are in James 3:17. One is pure, peaceable, gentle, entreatable, merciful, fruitful, steadfast, and honest. Those are 8 of the virtues. You find those in James 3:17. Amen. You don't have a lot for you to know. Then we're going to deal with the fruits of the Spirit in Galatians 5:22-23. Galatians 5:22-23. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace. Hear that word, long suffering. Gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. There's no law against this. When you operate in the fruits of the Spirit. Amen? You be in right standing with God. And here's the 9 virtues. The 9 that we have, 8 with the 9. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance. You understand the mind of Christ is an integrated mind. It has order, harmony, and unity. Christ and I have repeated. It has order, harmony, and unity. Each virtue works perfectly with all other virtues. In fact, the virtues enhance one another. The mind of Christ has no inner conflicts. Oh, you don't understand that. It's in harmony, it's in unity. And that's what he wants for his house. That's what he wants for his children. He wants his children to be in harmony and unity. There's no conflict. Each one compliments each other. That's what I'm trying to develop, that attitude in this particular ministry. Whereas each minister should enhance the other minister.
Amen.
You don't hear me now. It's critical. Who knows me, that's why I operate. And something I don't tolerate when I have friction and conflict, all that stuff up in, I don't like that stuff and I don't tolerate that. Yeah. With minister jealous of each other, I don't have time for that. There's no need for it. Each and every one of you is custom made by God. You are unique all by yourself. You are one of a kind. And God gave you a custom made anointing and a gifting made only for you. Why you be envious or jealous that somebody else's anointing? Why you want somebody else's anointing? That's not for you.
Amen.
You have to learn how to use what he gave you to the best of his ability. He holds you accountable for what he gave you. So some people's anointing you might admire, but you sure don't want to go through what they went through. Because you can't handle it.
Amen.
the pressures, the pain. Some people are not made for certain things. You break down, walk away. But when he gave you, you can handle it. Nobody is like you. That's why each and every one of you should celebrate each other. When one brother said to go forward, you celebrate them.
Yeah. Amen.
Your time comes, they do it for you. And that's what God wants.
Amen.
In this house, I don't know in other houses, he might want, he might not, but boy, he would get in this house. That way you see people come and people go. Holy Ghost running around here. I don't have to say nothing. This house has been chosen for special in-time work. For the second coming of Christ. Church. You have to open that door. Amen. Okay. Are y'all receiving anything tonight? I'm not gonna be for you long. You want me back again? Okay, Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. You remember that. Did Jesus ever express a desire of any kind as a person? Now we can go back to different ages. And this is what he said. Age 12, Luke 2, 49, he said, I must be about my Father's business at the age of 12. At the age of 30, in John 4:34, he said, my meat of food is to do the will of him that sent me to finish, accomplish his work. At the age of 32, John 6:38, he said, I came down from heaven not to do mine own will, but the will of him that sent me. Christ is our example. He's our forerunner. God wants us to be like Christ. We must be about our Father's business. He wants to fulfill his will in us. And that got to be our focus. Spiritually. So I know that's what mine is. If I do what I do. Not what I want to do. If I do what I want to do. Oh, this church should be different. Amen. I say to you, Apostle Ricky Barnett's ministry. None of y'all get in the pulpit. Amen? Nobody gonna get no impartations. But it's a surrendering of the will to the will of God in a person's mind. You have to surrender. He came to do his Father's will. That's why he go to Gethsemane, he said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will. Remember I said, the will, you have control over it. You have control over your will. You can will yourself to get out of that bed and come to church. You will yourself to go to that job and get that paycheck. You be sick. Oh, my God. Oh, boy, you. Oh, my God. You press your way through. When it comes to the will of the Father in your life, especially when you get into ministry, I thought ministry is very serious. And everybody should get this book. The book the Bible says to ministry is the scariest thing you ever read. I had a Bible book when I first started. They said, what the Bible says to me, it's scary. But God is expecting a minister. It's not like you think it is. It'll make you question, do I want to be in this? It's a higher accountability. And a lot of people get in this for the wrong reasons. You get in this, it's like you've been hired. And the creator's business, you've been hired. And he expected you to do the job. You have an operational procedure manual, the Bible. There's a higher accountability. And you're accountable to him and responsibility. The will. You didn't mean this in the spirit. About the will. What he wants from you, because when you were born, he gave you free will. He won't touch or mess with your will. That's why he said, choose ye this day who you're going to serve. That's one thing he will never do, mess with your will. And that's why we can't mess with nobody else's will. Then you're operating in witchcraft. Trying to control somebody. We can't do that. You have to understand that. You're operating in witchcraft. I mean, you're operating in witchcraft. You got to learn how to. Now, you have a certain age of accountability with children. You know? You're a certain age. Yeah. After when they get grown, that age on their own, they can go. Turn them over to God. What the Father wants from us, he wants us to present our will on a platter to him. That's the one thing that we have that we have to give to you. We have to present it to you. It's the surrendering of your will to the Father. He might have you to do some stuff you don't want to do. But when you surrender your will, it might not be pleasant. At first, but in the end, you will see the benefits of it. You may not be able to see it, but I didn't see no way I saw about Africa. No way I can see me being in Africa. So I didn't like that country. I kept living. My blessings came to surrender my will. My will. That's what I want to do. That you want me to do. Then you have to step into it by faith. Then it's unfolding to you. He already has a plan for you. And he has benefits for you hidden in your surrender of your will to him. Christ. Look, you can see it. It'll come, man. You want to drink out of that cup. You can see he had to go to the cross. And he had to go to it. All the pain, the beating, humiliation. But he saw past that. On his journey to the right hand of the Father, with all power. And you gotta look beyond some situations that might be unpleasant to you if you want to do. And if there's a blessing on the other side of that, but there's pain and suffering you have to go through to get to that. That's why you have to have the fruit of the Spirit. You know, prepare yourself for these things to happen. And you're going to work together for your good. God is going to bless you. He's going to bless you. So the main thing of blessing, I want for him, all I want to hear is well done. I don't want to hear depart from me. Oh, come on, somebody. You understand me? Depart from me, you work of iniquity. I never knew you. Why he never knew? Because you did not do what you were sent here to do. This has been predestinated, predestined. And he's not going to force you to do it. He's not going to force you to do it. He's not going to force you to do this. Come on, Lord. I dealt with the enemy's right here. That's what the one thing the Lord doesn't want. He don't want no envy. He don't want no strife. That's sensual, ungodly, and devilish. Envy and strife. It's devilish. It's other devil. And if you deal with those issues, you have to go to the Holy Spirit to get that out of you. Because it's going to be a problem down the line on your journey. You need to nip it in the bud right away. You understand me? You need to be envious and no God. Be jealous of nobody. Not all the strife. But you have peace. If you notice the fruits of the Spirit, they all complement each other. They work in harmony with each other. Love, joy, all that come together. Peace, all that come together. All of these things come together. It works together in harmony. It complements each other. God wants you to be unified, united in your soul bodies. He wants you to be in oneness as Christ the Father is in one. He wants you to be in oneness in yourself in Christ Jesus. The devil wants you split. He wants your race to be split. Some of y'all need to go back and make amends for some people in your past. Don't call it good. You'll be the bigger person. Whether it was your fault or not, take the blame. Take the blame. They cannot retaliate against Divine Kingdom, they want to kill you, so Divine Kingdom, forgive me. See, when you do that, you're releasing yourself. Change in your past. The enemy can bring back up in your future. That very person can be the person God has chosen to be a blessing to you in the future. Keep your past clean. I make those calls all the time. You hear me, whatever. I just call and apologize and take the blame for it. You got to learn to be a bigger person. Some of y'all saying, no, I can't. Well, you can. Do all the things. Through Christ, not through yourself. Through Christ. Well, you don't know what to do. Oh, yeah, so what? You still can do it. because you're on a spiritual journey. You could be setting up spiritual landmines for yourself with that mess in your future. You set your own traps up, your own hindrances up. This spiritual realm is nothing to play with. And I say, you know, I was shaken by that. But I talked to the young lady. You know, my spiritual son's wife, they died, and she saw Satan come, stepping through his spirit. This spiritual thing is nothing to play with. It's very legalistic. It has to be doors open. Or some contracts that was not broken in order for that to happen. So you have to, the way to alleviate that, you're trying to clear your past. So if you see anybody in the future, you'll be running away from them. That happened to me one time. I'll tell you a story about this guy who owed me some money, didn't pay me. I got mad. And I looked at the Lord, and I was against him. I said, Lord, I forgive you. But I was mad. It really said good. And I saw that guy in the moment face, and I said, I forgive you. When I saw him, that thing shook in my spirit. I saw the guy, and I said, I'm going another way. I don't want to face him. Come on. He let me know, boy, you didn't let that thing go. But you still have that thing in your spirit. I mean, I didn't get with you, you see. But your heart is far away. You have me in that boy's buddy. I didn't even bring up the money. And that's what I'm gonna do. Just joking about happening. Let it go. Mm-hmm. A lot of you have your diseases in your body. Tumors, cancer, and unforgiveness. I'm going to give you all. You got to release it. You got to call him. You got to leave a message. Clear it. It's on me and him. All of our talking to you in this place. You better let this out. If not, you allow the enemy to carry that into your future. See, remember, Satan is a strategist. He's not done. He's out to kill, steal, and to destroy. And he relentless. Are you sleeping? He still figuring out how to get you. And if we allow ourselves in the spiritual realm to get out of right standing with God through our disobedience to his word, we open ourselves up for the devil to have the legal right to use that very thing against us. And you're walking the same thing. Well, I didn't do that. But he said, it's the small foxes. It's for the lion. The little bitty things you don't think about is overlooked. You gotta start reflecting the way you spend the time with me. And just, you know, just hours upon hours, just it's me. My mind is spirit. It's the small foxes that spoil the vine on the small things you overlook. You don't even want to deal with. Those are the things that will creep up in your future if you don't expect it. I don't know who I'm talking to. Somebody need to clean up some mess in the spiritual realm, in their past. Already taking the phone call. The person don't have to want to be friends with you anymore, you have to release that. But how can two walk together unless they agree? You doing that for yourself. That's how you get spiritual promotion, doing things like that. You need to clean up some stuff from your past in relationship with people. So when you meet that person in the future, if that person crosses your path, you don't get shoved in that and run to somewhere else. Come on. Amen? You want to be at peace with all them. Let it be on them. Let them run from you. Amen? You want to be at peace with all them. You got to clean up the mess in your past, because the enemy want to use this for your future against you on your journey. When you don't expect it. Have you been driven a car and you had brand new tires, you had a blowout? She has an expensive bulge on her, she had a Cadillac and a bulge tire, expensive tire. And a blowout. Angry day, good, brand new tire. I didn't expect no blowout at 85 miles an hour. So the unexpected can happen. You see me? I'm gonna touch with this in the spirit of the Lord. But something up in here, you need to clean some stuff in the back. For you go to forward. Because the devil gonna use that against you in your future. That little smile. That's all the clean up the house. Clean up the house. Somebody really clean up the house. Yeah, we got all that stuff. So I'm not telling you something that I don't know myself. And it's amazing when you do it, you know you went wrong, you show you feel better. Because it's when you come into obedience with God, you have a peace. Because you did something you didn't want to do. That's how you get your promotions, your elevations in the spirit. Doing stuff like that. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I'm talking to you. You got to clean that stuff up. No, it was your fault. They belong, they belong to you. You can't have that continue, that conflict going on in the spiritual realm between you and that person. See, that's how people go and work witchcraft on people. You don't give them those kind of feelings. And that witchcraft stuff is real. And I when I went to Africa, I was like, oh, you know. But Lord, let me experience. Took me over the outside. And let it ram, see it myself. There's a whole other world. very legalistic. If you leave an opening, that's why it's so important, this class on developing the higher talents. I'm taking y'all on a mental journey that no other people take you in the churches on. So you sort of fan your mind, thinking these thoughts you haven't talked before. It really to really transform your thinking, transform your mind. Amen? Let's give the Lord a hand praise. I'm finished. Amen. If you have any questions, make any comments for anything I said, or you received anything in the spirit, for what I said in the teaching. Anybody have any comments? Stand up. It's the way you, the tone of your voice, the way you deliver the spirit of love.
And it's, I agree with you,
give Lord a hand, praise.
All of this, I'm sorry, Mama. I shouldn't have been like that with you, my little.
Africa. And the Lord said, this is the beginning of healing. And she said, Mom, if you want to come by, the doors are open for you. I have your favorite tacos. See, because what the apostle is saying is that you can be the bigger person. Because I was the bigger person for a whole 7 months. But it just took that one time. And I was being obedient to God. And I went down that street. And I said, I can't get near to her, Lord, because she didn't open the door, because she sees Christ up in her apartment. And she, the last time I spoke to her before this, she told me, stay away. I'm going to go to apostle on you. She wrote me a big old thing, you devil. You should be preaching and all that, but I took it. And I always told her I love her. And not just that, my grandson called me too a week ago, and he said, call me private. And he said, hey, Grandma. And I, last time I talked to him, I was like saying a lot of stuff. And then I told him, he said, I hurt you, grandson. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. And I said, I love you. Mm-hmm. Grandma loves you. And he got really calm. He said, okay, Grandma, I'll talk to you later. So these teachings are very important in your life and for our spirit. I do feel free. You know, because I do have other daughters, but it's something like when you got one, that very special one, that, you know, that's out there and you really want to be there for all the events that I've missed. But God is good because she invited me over and she wanted to talk more. And I just said, I'm going to just let the Lord continue doing the healing because family is first.
Amen. Good morning, hand for you. Well, praise God. So anybody else? Comment? Give the Lord hand praise. We have to keep, if we operate in